next couple of minutes, I'm going to demonstrate how to open a shared calendar. So I'm going to start by first sharing the calendar with somebody else and then opening that shared calendar. Because I'm using both Outlook and I need access to two accounts, I'm going to open the second account here via the Outlook webmail. The individual that wants to give me access in their account here. So we go under the calendar, click on the calendar, and then choose share on the top, or you can right click and choose sharing permissions. Either one of those, it's the same way. So then here under share with, I want to share the calendar from the online instructor account with a distance learning staff account. So I go here and share it with a DL staff. And then here you can choose how you want to share your calendar. It's very similar to the previous session that we did on sharing the calendar from Outlook. We can choose to give them the specific permissions, including the delegate permission. And in this case, I'm just simply going to say full details. That means that they can view the full details and then simply press send. Now, at this point, the recipient will get an email with a link to open the shared calendar. Notice, if I go to my email now, the distance learning staff account, and then notice you have the option for accepting the invitation to open that shared calendar. Now, if I choose to accept it from here, it takes me directly to my calendars, or I could have gone to calendars here sometime later and notice the shared calendar for online instructor. If you don't want it, you can simply uncheck it here and it will be not displayed. Of course, as you're working with a calendar, remember that you have these different views on the top as well. If you're working with shared calendars, remember you can also overlay those calendars. I don't have too many meetings at this point in these calendars because it's just for the sake of the tutorial, but you can actually right-click on one of the calendars here and choose overlay, and it's basically going to overlay one on top of the other. If you don't want the overlaying anymore, you can simply right-click and choose to change the overlay. Remember as well, when you're working with shared calendars or any types of calendars, you can search for specific appointments and things of that nature here on the top right side. And it should display the different meetings and search your calendar for all the different meetings that you have. To clear the filter, you simply click on the X here on the top right. If for some reason you don't want access to that specific calendar anymore, you can just right-click on it, choose Delete Calendar. That's going to delete it only from your account from showing up. It's not going to delete that individual's account. If for some reason you didn't get that email to open the shared calendar or the individual didn't send you the option for the email, you can also open a calendar by going to the Calendars option here, and then you click on Open a Shared Calendar or Open a Calendar. And you can choose from the address book or under the shared, open a shared calendar. And then you search for the name of the individual that has potentially shared it with you. And notice since they had shared it with you, the system just opens it and it will be added to your list of calendars. If they had not shared it with you already, then you can ask for permission to share it and they have to grant you permission first. That's how you share a calendar from Outlook Web and then open it here in Microsoft Outlook. The reason why we had to use the Outlook Web again, it was because of the dual account thing for the sake of this tutorial.